Hi, my name is Anjali Baradwa and I'm with DMC and I'm going to be talking to you about CRM. So CRM stands for Customer Relationship Management, and the first question that you might ask yourself is why even consider a CRM? So if you're like many organizations, you're probably managing your data somehow. Most likely it could be with an Excel spreadsheet. You could have multiple Excel spreadsheets and have lots of people managing different ones, and at the end of the day there's a lot of questions. You don't really know whose list is up to date, are your customers really happy, and how you're best managing these customers. So this is when you would consider a CRM system, to centralize all of your information into one location, have everybody be able to update the same area, the same database, and have real-time tracking of all the activities that happen with that customer. You can also use this outside of the sales organization and across different work groups. So if you wanted to be using it in the quality department or for technical support or for customer service, all of these people are able to manage their customers, and so you're sharing information. There are a lot of common misconceptions about CRM, including thinking it's too complex for their business, you know, we have a simple sales process, or it's too expensive, or even I'm going to have to change everything about the way I do my business in order to take on a CRM package. And these really aren't true. You just need to find the right CRM package for your company. With dynamic CRM, there's a number of different modules. There's a marketing module where you're able to send out targeted marketing campaigns. For example, people who are in a particular geographical area or people who are looking for a certain product. You have the sales module, which is what most people know it for. You can also use it for service and support, track customer support calls, and just the overall management module to be able to look at the data for your sales activities as a whole. Here's some screenshots of how CRM is being used. The first one was with lead and opportunity management. So if you have a new lead, there's going to be a process that it goes through and hopefully becomes an opportunity. You're going to want to be able to qualify, develop, propose, and then eventually close these opportunities. Account and contact management is done in CRM as well. Being able to see all the contact information, who are all the players that are involved, and how who the decision makers are within the process. The management dashboards can have various different kinds of information on there, including what's in the pipeline, who's on the leadership board for the most amount of sales, what opportunities are really big that we should be keeping our eyes on, and perhaps geographically, where are our top customers located? And because Dynamic CRM is a Microsoft product, it does integrate very well with SharePoint for the document management, keeping your actual proposals in one place. With Office 365, there are now three very good options for how to utilize CRM. There's the on-premise CRM, which people are accustomed to, an online CRM, which is in the cloud, and then there's also a very small product called CRM Lite, which you develop on SharePoint. If you've ever considered a CRM option in the cloud, you've probably looked at some of these different options before. And overall, the idea is that with CRM, you're getting a lot of value for your money. You're not having to increase your cost for the more options that you want, and you're getting a Microsoft product. With CRM, you are able to better manage your customers by having all of the data in one central location.